Hi, and welcome to the second video in my cable management series. In the first video, I talked about how I use many different cameras, as well as a focus control and a do control system to make my astrophotography life possible. With my telescope, I will have all of those cables riding off the back of it, with the exception of the do control, which would be here at the front. And that means I've got two sources of cables that would be hanging off of my telescope, one in the front and one in the back. And that creates a very difficult and unpredictable balance situation. And I know that cables don't exactly make a lot of mass on a telescope, but what they do provide is an opportunity for that cable to snag on something. And that snagging creates a tugging effect on wherever it's pulling on, either the front or the rear of the telescope. And that tugging does offset the balance of the telescope, and it does make your mount have to work harder to overcome that as well. If you have a lot of cables hanging off the back of the telescope and you bundle them together with Velcro straps or rubber bands or some sort of cable sleeve, you're concentrating all of that mass in one area, and the combined weight of those cables may be as much as a pound or a pound and a half. More complicated setups may require even more cabling, and you may have 2 pounds worth of cabling, and that 2 pounds is a significant amount of weight. And as it moves with the telescope, it shifts that balance point, and those cables can potentially snag on something, again, further increasing the amount of tension applied to the telescope tracking drive. So this video is going to show you how you can start with a simple telescope setup that we would use for visual and add things to it that make cable management very, very simple, basically trivial, where cable management is not an issue at all. And so to start with, we all should have a telescope. Obviously, you wouldn't be watching this video if you weren't at least curious about how to do this, if you were maybe thinking about buying a telescope. A telescope will connect to a tracking system via a dovetail plate, and hopefully is held in place by a couple of high quality tube rings like I've got here. And these are clamshell style tube rings, and they've got holes drilled across the top from stellar view that allow me to add additional accessories to the top. And I can put guide scope tube rings on here and then carry this guide scope right on top like this. And I've got an auto guiding setup that rides right on the back of my telescope. But today I'm going to show you that with the use of a second dovetail and a couple of off-the-shelf hardware items, we can make a little bit of a chassis here that will sit on top of the tube rings like so. And this will give us a platform for adding all of the accessories that we want to use with our astrophotography, as well as a way to manage all of the cabling that comes with it. Now that I've shown you why we need to have this dovetail plate and platform put on the telescope, I want to show you kind of how I put it together. And really, the key thing for what I've come up with are these little L brackets here. And I got these vinyl-coated L brackets from a local hardware store. And then, as discussed before, I've got this Lowe's Mandy 14-inch dovetail. And I've got some Velcro already put on here. I kind of cut it to form just because I didn't want to have a whole bunch of loose fabric here. The L brackets themselves also have a little bit of Velcro on them, and that's going to hold some of the items that were attached to my tripod legs. They will now attach to the Velcro here. And on the other side, again, I've got more Velcro. I've got a black piece here that came with one of my accessories we'll discuss later, and a white piece here that's this industrial strength. When this is mounted to my telescope, this is the top. This is the surface that mates to the tube rings, and there's two holes here and two holes here that I had to drill the threads out. There should be no shift or anything while the telescope moves. This is very tightly affixed to the telescope tube rings. Now, part of getting this all to fit together the way that I needed it to, and make sure that I could adequately manage all of my cabling, I found that bolting
directly on the telescope tube rings was not the perfect solution. And what I'm going to try and show you is that the spacing between the OTA and this dovetail plate is very tight. So bear with me while I bring the camera down. As you can see in there, I've got maybe an inch of clearance. And if I wanted to run cables in here from whatever accessories get Velcroed on, it doesn't leave me a whole lot of room. So I came up with a solution that seems to be working very well, and that is to use these spacers. And I'll show you how that works. So again, at the hardware store where I purchased my L brackets, I was able to pick up a couple of these 1-inch spacers. And they're about, I'd say about a 1/2 inch internal diameter. And that gives me a wide, stable base. These are some sort of steel alloy, stainless steel. So they're pretty hard. They will expand or contract when it's cold, but because they're all the same and they're made from extruded process, they should all have the same diameters, the same density, the same properties. They should all expand and contract at the same rate. And what I do is I just set these on over the bolt holes that I'm going to be using, like so, and they give me an additional 1-inch standoff from my tube rings for my dovetail to sit on, like that. And now, as I bring the camera down again for you to take a look, you can see that there is a lot more clearance in there. If I needed to run cables, I have got all the room in the world to run those cables. And that's actually going to play a big part in how I manage my cables. So let's go ahead and get this tightened up. And in the next video, I will show you how I begin to attach all of my accessories to this. And we have cable management come into play.
Thanks for taking the time today to watch my video. I hope you've learned something new, and I hope you've been inspired to get under the stars and take a look at something through a telescope. If you like what I've been doing, please take a moment to subscribe to my channel. It'll be a great way for you to show your appreciation, and it's the best way to be notified of when new videos get uploaded. Thank you, and clear skies.